India has been trying to develop its own jet engine to develop its own jet making capability. Hello everyone, welcome to the Power Academy. In this topic, we will going to discuss about why the India is developing its own jet engine Kaveri. So to start this topic, we will going to talk about what the Kaveri jet engine is all about and about its development. So let's talk briefly about the Kaveri and its development. These are all fact based. You can get these things from internet, from any kind of websites or Indian government's website. The GTRE GTX-35VS is an afterburning turbofan project developed by Gas Turbine Research Establishment, a lab under Defense Research Development Organization, which is DRDO. In 1986, DRDO was authorized to launch a program to develop an indigenous power plant for light combat aircraft. In 1989, the Cabinet Committee on Security has sanctioned the indigenous Kaveri engine project in 1989. The project, which ran for 30 years with an expenditure of 2,035.56 crore, saw the development of 9 prototype engine and 4 core engine. A total of 3,217 hours of engine testing was conducted. An engine has also completed the altitude test and flying test based trials. India basically have to take this engine to the Russia. Why Russia? Because the flying test bed facility is not available in India right now. That is why to conduct the flying test base is operations or the experiments, India have to go to the Russia to fetch this engine into the engines of the IL-76 or Dornier 228 aircraft, which is not available with the Indian government or the Indian defense facility. That is why India basically carries those engines to the Russia to conduct the flying test based experiments. And also India go with this engine to the Europe to conduct the other tests, because the test facilities are not available yet in India. In the next part, we will going to talk about why the Kaveri engine is in the news now. Because since the pace of the work on the dry Kaveri engine development as an offshoot of Kaveri engine is processing well, and soon it will head to the Russia by the mid 2022 to commence a series of tests that are planned on IL-76 aircraft. As I said, dry Kaveri will replace one of the 4 engine of IL-76 and the flying test base to be carried out up to 12 km maximum altitude and the maximum forward speed of 0.7 Mach. The dry Kaveri engine will be able to generate 73 to 78 kilonewton class of thrust when the afterburner is engaged. Recently, the Safran, a French multinational aircraft engine manufacturer that carried out the technical audit of the Kaveri engine, cleared it for the in-flight trials of the new engine. But the main problem they have detected is that it's related to its core. So India has to improve that engine by improving its core. So in the third part, we will going to talk about that why India is trying to develop its own jet engine. That's because India has already developed the indigenous light combat aircraft HAL Tejas MK-1 and the MK-1A, which is India's indigenously developed aircraft. India is also planning to develop the more advanced version of the Tejas MK-2 with 5th generation's advanced medium combat aircraft with estimated cost of 15,000 crore, which is 5th generation's advanced medium aircraft, which is called the AMCA. So to develop the AMCA fighters, India needs its own engine technology. So that is also a concern for the India, because the 5th generation fighters are strategically important for anyone's defense. That is why India is trying to develop this jet engine. As we all know that India has the aircraft carriers. So the India is trying to develop the twin engine deck based fighter. Why? Because the India's fighter aircraft, which India used over the these five aircraft carrier, they are the MiG-29K. But these MiG-29K fighters are very rare these days and the unavailable in the international, their spares are unavailable into the international market because the Russia is not making this aircraft anymore, because Russia do not have the viable or the working aircraft carrier. They have scrapped this aircraft carrier program since before, when they disintegrated, when the Soviet Union was disintegrated. They are trying to develop the more missile system instead of making the aircraft carrier. And the India is also planning to develop the aircraft carrier to replacement of 60,000 and the 65,000 ton. India is also planning to develop the third aircraft carrier, whose replacement will be 60,000 and the 65,000 ton, which is more the whatever the aircraft carrier India have. India have INS Vikramaditya and the INS Vikrant. INS Vikrant is indigenously developed aircraft carrier. India is also planning to acquire the Dassault Rafale marine aircraft and also the FA-18. So to reduce those things, to reduce the imports, India is also trying to develop its own jet engine. So therefore, India need to have their own engine technology to equip these strategically important aircrafts for its very important military assets. As I said, the fifth generation aircraft is a very important military asset. Tejas MK2, deck-based fighters, they are all very important militarily strategic assets. These days, the LCA Tejas MK1 and the 1A is equipped with General Electric A404 engine with a maximum thrust of 75 kN after burning. If the Kaveri can upgrade it, then it could be generated to the 75 to 80 kN, which is more than General Electric's F404. So, at least for now, the India is trying to develop its own to reduce the import cost. India is also trying to reduce its import cost because these fighter engines are very, very expensive. India have to spend foreign reserves to acquire those engines. So, to reduce the import cost, to reduce the burden on the Indian economy, India has to develop its own engine technology. So that is why India is also trying to develop its own engine technology. So now in the last one, we will going to talk about what is my view about these developments. In my view, this is a very good initiative by Indian government. India is importing so many military equipments these days, so many from the countries like the Russia, USA, France, Britain and the others. India has been acquiring the Russian goods since the independence of India. From 1947 to 2020, Indian military assets are almost equipped with 70% of Russian military goods. So that is why India is also trying its dependence on the Russian military goods and also trying to dependence on the USA, France, Britain, these kind of countries, because their goods are all based on their parameters. So India needs its own military goods on the basis of its own parameter, own country's parameter, what are the needs, because India do have the two hostile neighbors, China and the Pakistan, to fight the two front war. India needs that kind of fighter aircrafts, that kind of military equipment. So that is why India is trying to build its own and jet engines these days. And also these days, the India is also trying to establish herself as a military equipment exporting nation, not the importing nation. And over and above that, so many Asian and the African nations are also interested to acquire the Indian military goods, because Indian military goods are very good in quality. They are very less expensive comparing to the French goods, French military goods, or the USS military goods, or the Britain's military goods. So that is why these countries are trying to acquire the Indian military goods. Recently, for example, recently the Philippines is interested to acquire the BrahMos supersonic missile systems. BrahMos is a state-of-the-art supersonic missile system. No country cannot counter the BrahMos missile systems, and the Philippines is buying that missile system to counter the Chinese aggression in South China Sea. And they are also buying the HAL Dhruv MK3 and also the Dornier 228 aircraft. Malaysia is interested about the LCA Tejas MK1, and the Egypt is also interested about the HAL LCA Tejas Mark 1 and also Mark 1A. Argentina is also interested about these fighters, these MK1 and the MK1A. Over the Pakistan's and the Chinese made JF-17, which is inferior in quality. Therefore, to encourage the Indian manufacturers of military equipment, India recently put ban on the military equipment's import from the foreign nations. The Indian government is trying to encourage its own industry to making the goods for the country, making the military goods for the country, and making the goods for the countries, those who are in need. And Indian government is also trying to encourage its own Make in India program and also Atmanirbhar Bharat program. India is trying to self-reliance on the military goods. So that is why India is making its own jet engine. Now we reach to the question part in our today's questions. And the question is, in which year India first tested intercontinental ballistic missile? The first option is 2010, second is 2008, third is 2012, fourth is 2014. The next question is a broad question, which is related to the UPSC exam related, which is conducted by the UPSC in India. So question is, how the India's economical growth will going to affect the South Asian geopolitics? You can explain it, you can give me the answer, you can give me the answer, you can give me the answer through the email address if you want to. So thank you very much. Thank you for your attention.